Who is Elite Business Machines? Starting in 1984 with the development of large cutting devices from 110 inches down to 28 inches, with engineering and expertise, they became very quickly the top of the line in the industry. With three knife trimming devices that would do book publication plans to trim all three sides of a book at one time, as well as developing systems integration for groups like Parker Brothers for inserting pieces into the Monopoly game boxes. As lead engineers in the field of cutting devices, now EBM, or Elite Business Machines, manufactures a small end paper cutting device from 26 inches and below using the same industrial standards as before in the larger machines. The heaviest built machine with the highest quality of integration of logic. With over 30 years in expert engineering, we know paper cutters.
Hello, my name is Troy Garrett. I'm with Elite Business Machines. Today we're going to talk about specific things that are necessary in buying a paper cutter. You have to learn what you're purchasing in order to get your value out of these products. We're going to go over different types of clamping mechanisms because we feel like that is one of the most important criteria in buying a paper cutter. If you cannot hold the paper still when the knife is coming down through it, then you're not going to get a quality cut, which also means your cut's going to vary from top to bottom of your stack. It also means if you can't hold the paper still and you can't clamp it properly, that the amount that you can cut it each time for accuracy is going to be smaller and smaller. You're going to find out a lot of machines have a 3-inch girth on them. They'll handle 3 inches of material, but they're only accurately going to cut a 1-inch stack. And that's because they cannot properly clamp 3 inches of material and hold it still while the blade is coming through it. So we're going to go over cam clamping devices. You're going to learn a lot about them. We're going to go over spring-loaded devices, machines that clamp paper with springs. We're going to go over hand clamping devices and where they stand in the marketplace. And then last, we're going to go over electrical clamping devices to where you can separately clamp and cut, but you also have a stronger, depending on the motor clamping, than the other types of devices offer. There's a huge difference in production, of which you'll learn the difference between lifting and closing a plastic lid every time you make a cut or have to change something, or something that stops automatically when you put your hand in front of it, which allows you to operate at all times from a production level. So you will find out if you've already bought a copier or some type of press that the paper cutter is the second most important thing in running your whole establishment because it gives you the ability to do all the rest of those jobs. So I hope you enjoy this. It's put a lot of time into it, putting it together for you. So if we can help you in any way, give us a call. Thank you.
First, let's look at cutting a club sandwich. The pressure that you hold down on a club sandwich will cut a club sandwich in half, of course. But if you don't hold it properly and the pressure is not proper on the sandwich, you're going to end up with all the meat and all the internal fixings to the middle. If you clamp a club sandwich properly, though, and you cut down through it, then you get a nice, clean, straight cut without the destruction of the sandwich. This is very similar to cutting paper. You can only cut a club sandwich properly by holding the sandwich down with force. Proper pressure avoids the downward draw, the slippage of the sandwich meat from the force of the knife blade going through it. Common sense tells us that. So, in cutting a club sandwich, if it's held properly, you get a nice clean cut from top to bottom without the destruction of the material in the middle. But we're not cutting club sandwiches. Only strong clamping force can keep paper from slipping. Good clamping force, better known as PSI, or pounds per square inch, of clamping pressure. Correct clamping keeps the cut length the same from top to bottom of the stack. What is the minimum clamping pressure needed to accurately cut a 1-inch or 2-inch stack of the most common paper stocks? Also remember, as the cutting blade dulls, more clamping pressure is needed to cut a full stack with accuracy. These are minimum following standards. Clamping pressure for a 2 or 1-inch stock depending on the stock being cut. For 20-pound and 60-pound offset, cutting a 2-inch stack of paper, the minimum clamping pressure is 700 pounds or 700 PSI with a sharp blade. For 20-pound bond or 60-pound offset, a 1-inch stack of paper, The minimum clamping pressure is 300 pounds or 300 psi with a sharp blade. A 2-inch stack of card stock or index stock is almost double. Proper clamping is almost double the PSI from regular paper stocks. The minimum clamping pressure is 1,350 pounds of 1,350 PSI with the sharp blade on card stocks. What we've learned is this: minimum clamping pressure for bond, texture, offset, 2-inch stack, 700 PSI. A 1-inch stack, 300 PSI. Minimum clamping pressure for business card, index, and other 80-pound plus hard stocks, a 2-inch stack is 1,350 psi, a 1-inch stack is 600 psi. These are low clamping pressures for newly sharpened blades, not as the blade gets dull. Higher is required after that. Paper cutting clamping devices for over 1-inch stacks or higher should be 1,350 to 3,000 PSI to maintain production. A dull blade or high stack needs more cutting force to push the blade through the stack, requiring more clamping pressure to keep the stack in place. We're going to show you different clamping devices, showing you what does and what does not work, and why. At the end of this video, we're going to give you some alternative to the economics of buying paper cutters. These are just a few of the gauges that we use in doing our test: electronic, liquid, and spring gauges. When measuring clamping pressure, an orifice is pushed down onto a bulb or onto a center point. Usually it's a clamp or some type of device that's forced down. This puts pressure on it and gives the gauge a reading from there. There are many types of clamping gauges that are used, or force gauges that are used. The most accurate, the PSI certified gauges at the highest degree, are the electronic ones because they can get down to 1 pound of pressure. Others are based on 5 pound increments. With certified gauges, we've done extensive testing on clamping pressure. Let's review clamping types, their cost, and their differences. In this series, we're going to cover number one, lever cam clamping, which is overall the weakest of all clamping devices. Number two, the weak to medium devices, is spring clamping, depending on what manufacturer you buy from. Then number three is the heaviest clamping pressure. It's either manual or electric driven, and it is the weak to the strong devices, and it's spindle clamping. These are a few of the machines we've tested. A full list is available upon request. Let's start with number one, the low pressure cam lever clamping manual cut paper cutters. The low pressure devices is basically a cam, and as the cam is pulled over, a spring with a brake holds it in place. As the spring weakens, of course, then the cam starts to kick up. It's boasted at over 250 pounds of pressure and retailing it starting at $1,800 in this category. Once again, remember the clamping pressure is necessary for production. The following are ads from other marketing companies on these products.
Adding Safety Lock provides additional safety and peace of mind. The patented lever-activated manual clamping system allows the clamp pressure to be easily adjusted for different paper qualities.
Bring the blade down, paper clamp here on the back, make sure that's engaged before you bring the paper cutting blade all the way down. It's extremely easy, very little pressure needed. Once you're done cutting, just lift that back up. I have very precisely and accurately cut an 11-inch stack right in half. Very similar to the MBM4305. This is extremely affordable. It's definitely within the budget of most people who are looking for a stack paper cutter that is designed for daily use. This stack paper cutter is excellent for light to medium volume paper cutting jobs, and I personally recommend it.
Let's look at cam lever manual clamping electric cut that's over $4,000. And please remember our pressure settings that are necessary for card stocks or things of this nature for just a 1-inch stack.
Over 4 inches, which will be our cut. The laser light on the paper shows you just where the slice will be. The lever-activated fast-action clamp holds your papers down in place with over 250 pounds of pressure. For safety reasons, it requires both hands to activate the blade. Push the buttons on both ends of the front. Lift the shield, release the lever, and remove your projects. The Triumph 4315 has a cutting height of 1.5 inches and a cutting width of 16 7/8 inches. For safety and control reasons, you have to hold the buttons all the way down for the entire slice. If you remove them too early, it will not make it through the whole pass. For precision cutting on large projects, this is a great machine.
Next, we're going over electric cut spring clamping paper cutters. These range in low to somewhat mid pressures, but not high at all. They're great for office environments, very similar to the lever clamp system, but not much as a production model. Next, let's look at the spring-loaded clamping systems. The spring-loaded clamp comes down as the knife is driven by a motor, and of course both run together. That means you cannot clamp separate from the motor from the cut cycle. That's the biggest disadvantage. They are good machines for startups, but they are not a high production machine. And they range from 155 to 400 pounds of clamping pressure. As the springs get weaker, the clamping pressure gets weaker. Once again, it's a startup machine. They range from $995 to $4,900. Let's listen to some manufacturers.
Its electromechanical blade and clamp drive ensure optimum workflow. Both the blade and the clamp are activated simultaneously.
As a startup machine, these are probably one of the betters for a startup machine. They're not heavy investment machines. They do not have a robust clamping pressure, but they can produce at least small volumes on a consistent level. This unit is up to 315 pounds of clamping pressure, and we have seen them go as far as 350 on various models out here. They're not designed for high production, but they're a great office machine. And if you're cutting quarter-inch stacks or 3/8-inch stacks of material, something like that, you can get some material out of these. They're a good startup machine. As an office environment machine, these are acceptable machines. They have an excellent digital back gauge with them, and all models do. But once again, they are a low-end machine with low clamping pressure. The models can go up to 350 pounds of clamping pressure depending on what manufacturer you buy it from. But what you're still getting is a low production machine with small stacks to be cut to keep any accuracy in them because they are spring loaded. Once again, what we have learned is that spring clamping is a mid-range type of clamping, low to mid-range depending on who the manufacturer is. Remember your clamping pressure. So as you buy machines to evolve production, make sure that you buy something that can start getting you there as quick as possible. Low pressure side spindle clamping manual cut paper cutter. The side spindle clamp is the weakest of the spindle type of clamping devices. Acceptable as an office environment machine, the side manual clamping devices are the weakest of the clamping devices, especially for the spindle end. Let's listen to manufacturers discuss what they think about their products.
It's the Premier 7000E manual stack paper cutter. Premier paper cutters are designed for heavy-duty applications where accurate cuts are essential.
Next, we have the same manual clamping pressure in the middle, but we have an electric cut. And the price shows the difference, but you can get clamping pressure from these machines. The center spindle on one of the manual paper cutters can give you a very good clamping pressure, up to 1700 pounds depending on the strength of the individual that's cranking down on it. Many manufacturers have put out a product like this for years, and many copy shops have been extremely successful with getting good results out of these machines. Once again, it is manual, but you can at least get enough clamping pressure to get a stack of paper out of it with some accuracy.
While you're cutting your paper, the spindle clamping system applies even pressure along the entire cutting width. As just one of the many safety cutting systems, the hinge transparent safety guard on the front of the machine will lock automatically while you cut. The all-metal construction 705 manual tabletop cutter.
For the strongest in the lower range, we have the high pressure, top spindle clamping, electric cut paper cutter. Manual clamp with strength and electric cut on a paper cutter.
10D with an electric blade drive and a manual spindle clamping system also has a safety lock and key, a main switch, and a hinged transparent safety guard for the front table. The hand crank allows users to adjust the precise spindle-guided back gauge quickly and easily to the required cutting position. The disengage mechanism on the crank prevents the measurement from being accidentally altered. The clamp pressure of the manual spindle clamp, which is guided on both sides, can be individually adjusted by the large hand wheel for different paper qualities. If the clamp and the electronically controlled safety cover are closed, the cut is actuated by two push buttons.
It's an electric cutter and is capable of cutting a maximum width of 40 centimeters. This size is perfect for A4 paper. Now let's see how easy it is to operate. The size of the cut is adjusted by rotating the handle at the front of the machine. Rotating the handle moves the back gauge to the desired dimension. The convenient and easy to read digital display is located on the front table. It displays the location of the back gauge to 1/10 of a millimeter accuracy. This easy to use feature allows the operator to accurately cut jobs that require consistency. The manual clamping system is operated by using a hand wheel at the top of the machine. This system provides up to 3 times more clamping force than lever-operated machines offered by competitive brands. Higher clamping force significantly improves cutting accuracy. A cut is activated by lowering the auto-release safety shield to the closed position. Push and hold the two cut buttons to make the cut. After the knife has completed the cut, release the cut buttons. The knife and safety shield automatically return to their up position. The auto-release safety shield is an exclusive feature found only on the Spartan 150. This feature reduces handling of the safety shield by 50%, dramatically improving productivity.
Well, what we've learned so far is besides electric clamping, top spindle clamping has the highest range of clamping pressure for the manual clamping devices. Vendors speaking for themselves on their knowledge of paper cutting. What we've learned also is the internet ads. Everyone will suggest you buy their product. Even low production models are said to be ready for big jobs.
530M does not have it. Very similar to the NVM4305. This is extremely affordable. It's definitely within the budget of most people who are looking for a stack paper cutter that is designed for daily use. This stack paper cutter is excellent for light to medium volume paper cutting jobs, and I personally recommend it.
The lever-activated fast-action clamp holds your papers down in place with over 250 pounds of pressure. For safety reasons, it requires both hands to activate the blade. Push the buttons on both ends of the front. Lift the shield, release the lever, and remove your projects. The whole pass. For precision cutting on large projects, this is a great machine.
Premier 7000E Manual Stack Paper Cutter. Premier paper cutters are designed for heavy-duty applications where accurate cuts are essential.
What we've learned about production. Clamping pressure is everything for accurate, precise cut at a high stack. Spindle clamping is the strongest clamping method in low-range products. Plastic safety shields slow down production. Manual back gauge knobs can change settings accidentally just by being hit.
The manual clamping system is operated by using a hand wheel at the top of the machine. This system provides up to 3 times more clamping force than lever-operated machines offered by competitive brands. Higher clamping force significantly improves cutting accuracy. The knife and safety shield automatically return to their up position. The auto-release safety shield is an exclusive feature found only on the Spartan 150. This feature reduces handling of the safety shield by 50%, dramatically improving productivity.
Years ago, we realized that we could not compete with the Chinese in
selling a quality product against an inexpensive throwaway item. So we decided to sell our quality manufactured items and as well as their cheap, inexpensive throwaway paper cutters. We know all the machines coming out of China. We sell machines into China, and there's a huge difference between a throwaway paper cutter and one that's designed to last 15 to 25 years. And so when you buy a machine that comes out of China, whether it's from us, as we will import one and sell it to you, but we're very honest with you about it, buy backup control boards and other components. The machines are designed to last anywhere from 6 months to 2 years before motors start going out and things of this nature. You have to understand the how the Chinese operate. There's 10 to 12 manufacturers that manufacture the cutters in China. They all compete with one another. They all buy the same framework from the casting plants and then put their own combination of products on them to put a product out into the industry at the cheapest cost that they can manufacture at. And with doing this, sometimes some of the manufacturers will put four different control boards on a particular machine within 1 year. So make sure you have backups. Looking at the machines that are being bought in from China that are sold on Amazon and eBay, you start with the spring-loaded machine that is clamping and cutting all with the cut button, no special clamping on it, and they're $900 to $1,000 in price. Then you come up with one that has an electric clamping motor that's a real small motor, and they're $1,400 to $1,600 in the price range with 380 pounds of clamping pressure. And then you come up with the 19.3-inch new style machines with 420 pounds of clamping pressure on the smaller motor-driven one from $1,600 to $2,500. And then the follow-ups behind them, there's about 10 different manufacturers of these items, all of them using the same cast frames, 480 pounds of clamping pressure on this particular model, and then we check the next model, which is also 480 pounds of clamping pressure. The problem is that we have tried putting larger clamping motors on them, and they break the frames on the machines because the machines are designed as inexpensive as possible to compete with one another out of Asia on who can sell the most machines at the lowest manufacturing cost. So this is what you get out of Asia. What makes our paper cutter different than a machine being brought in from China with the same capacity and the same width, 19 inches? You need at least 2,800 pounds of clamping pressure for a 3-inch stack of paper. That's so the paper will not pull over when the blade is going down through it. This is called paper draw. Unfortunately, the Chinese paper cutters boast a whole 480 pounds of clamping pressure, which is enough for approximately a 1/2-inch stack of paper to cut it accurately. Next, we're going to go over the industrial paper cutters that are designed to last and to produce for a long period of time, anywhere from 15 to 25 years. These machines are designed for copy and print centers for under $9,500, and they're built to work for a long period of time without breakdowns and not a throwaway item.
The Triumph 4850 automatic cutter has a cutting width of 18 5/8 inches and a cutting height of 3 inches. The 4850 has a safety lock and key, a main switch, and a hinge transparent safety guard for the front table. The hand crank allows the precise spindle guided back gauge to be adjusted quickly and easily to the desired cutting position. The disengaged mechanism on the crank prevents the measurement from accidentally being altered. The exact position of the back gauge can be viewed in the digital display for the measurement readout, which can be switched from centimeters to inches. The optical cutting line with bright and durable LEDs allow for quick and convenient cutting and trimming. Patented Easy Cut Blade activation bars provide a true two-hand operation for added safety.
The 4850 paper cutter, manufactured by EBA, sold by MBM, the Triumph 4850D electric clamping paper cutter, can be purchased for as low as $87.99 and will definitely cut a good ream stack of paper. It has a clamping pressure up to 2,200 pounds, and so it averages 2,200, and is a good product. Very well built to last a long time. At Elite Business Machines, we boast the heaviest clamping pressure in the industry for electric paper cutters. Our 19 PLC paper cutter clamps at 3,400 pounds of clamping pressure, allowing you to cut a 3-inch stack of paper with no problem at all. No paper draw, no paper being pulled over. Accuracy is what you look for when cutting paper. That's right, with the EBM PLC 19-inch, you have the capability of cutting a 3-inch stack of paper accurately. Our programmable soft touch keypad allows you to pre-program 99 different cut channels so you can keep your jobs without having to pre-program them over and over. Our back gauge control knob on the center of the machine helps you to drive your back gauge. It's a multiple speed control knob, and to the right of course goes backwards, to the left it'll bring it forward. A hard crank will get it at a fast speed. A light crank will bring it down to a thousandth of an inch at a creep speed. And you can watch your digital keypad to get to the location that you want to get at. That's just one way of going into the settings. Or you can go to the digital keypad and utilize that. To date, we have absolutely no competitors in the marketplace in our price range. On the digital keypad, if we want 17 inches, we just plug that in, or we use the arrows to run to it the same way we did the center back gauge control knob. We make sure that we rigorously test every machine before it leaves our assembly plant. Can't afford the paper cutter you need? We can help. Maintaining production is vital. At EBM, we offer an 80% purchase towards trade up towards any of our EBM production paper cutters. That's right, 80% towards any upgrade. EBM will be with you as you grow. We also offer creative financing and many ways to get you into a basic system, and then we'll take it back in on trade as you grow with your production levels. We offer a full line of startup industrial hydraulic paper cutters. The series shows you that we stay in well above the competition in features, automation, and production. Not just in clamping, not just in production, also in quality build, also in support, also in economic decision making. EBM is here to support you. Thank you.